Hello everyone, my name is the real B.I.G., aka the Big Italian Gamer, and welcome to one of my first games, well, official games, Coffee Talk. I really think that this game has a message that I really like, but it's also very chill and nice, and it slowly pushes it. And this is set in the modern era. 2020, where we got all this shit going on. So, I really think it's down to earth, and it really helps. Okay. Now, I'm gonna use my roller. Yes, it is. Here we go. Seattle, 2020. A city filled with dreams and madness. A time when the great war between races is but a footnote in history. A time when anyone can dream of being whatever they want to be, and have those dreams crushed before they even can be discussed. Oh, how I felt that. But still, it is a place and time where everything can happen. I also like the style. I like how they put the credits in first. That's nice. I really do. That's nice. When the dwarves have emerged from their caves, I forgot to say, when the elves have left their forest to start their startups, when the dwarves have emerged from their caves to start their automotive empires. When the orcs have put down their axes and started using computers to improve their lives. As a D&D player, I would think dwarves, or maybe the elves, would have started that first, other than the orcs. But I'm not the judge here. When humans live among them, as driven as ever, it is a city that holds the many dreams and stories of its people. Most of these stories are left untold, but some few find solace in their embrace of bricks and wood and glass. They are told over drinks, and then take up residence in some stranger's memories. The city stands a coffee shop, a place that is only open when the sun is sleeping, a place where people share their stories, and these are their stories. This could be a good game. I know it. This could be a great game. I can already feel it. I can feel it in my bones. Hey, I, Gino. No. Hey, I, Gino. How's the night so far? It's calm, as usual. We've got a slight problem, though. Just the face. At a slight problem. Ooh. What happened? The supplier made some logistical errors. I don't have half of my ingredients today. Man, that's a bummer. Don't worry. I can still serve the caffeine you desperately need. That's good to hear. Anyway, let me set things up first. You're our first customer, after all. Don't worry, take your time. Have a right. writer, not an editor. Distinction. So I'm used to taking things slow. Writer's block again. You got that right. What are you writing now? Do you remember my plan to... Pardon the interruption. The machine's ready. Do you want your... Didn't you say this was open at like 9 o'clock or whenever the sun sets? You're gonna do a triple shot of espresso now? How stupid can you be? Okay, whatever the customer wants. And if you forget how to make it, just check your phone, okay? Anyway, I need that triple shot espresso. We have such an array. Blacker than the moonless night, hotter and more bitter than hell itself. Don't diss espresso like that, alright. Oh, he's even got the fancy machine. I am jealous. We own an espresso machine, by the way. Special for my only customer tonight. Okay. That aroma. The aroma of tar that espresso without sugar is. Just saying. Exactly what you need, Anyway, where were we? Plan to do something. Yes, that. It's not that I hate writing stories for the newspaper, you know. It seems like the right time for something bigger. So, a novel? Yes. It sounds so simple when I was making the plan. At least you still have your job. In case things go awry. I like that laugh. Something wrong? No, you were right. You said something I should have thought about myself. What are you talking about? You know who owns the Evening Whispers? GRA Media, right? Yes, because I know this. And they are also the biggest book publisher in the country. So when an opportunity presented itself, I took it. So what do you mean by opportunity? Well, I bumped into one of the big guys in the elevator. So naturally, I pitched my book idea. Gonna say something? Come on, don't look at me like that. Are you for real? Yeah, I know. It was such a stupid thing to do. So how did they react? Thankfully, he'd seen my short stories. So he challenged me. If I can get a draft ready in a month, he'll pull some strings. And get the fiction publishing division to sign me up for a publishing deal. That sounds great! I was actually about to say that. That actually sounds great. on with the evening whispers? Do you have time to do both? That's the hard part. I've been secretly working on a novel during office hours. I'm falling behind on newspaper deadlines. If the chief finds out, she'll probably kick me out. That's rough, buddy. That's the same energy. That's rough, buddy. Ouch. Avatar reference, by the way. It's a good show, believe me. Well, at least you've got a month to finish the initial draft. That was last. How stupid are you? Oh, excuse me for being a realist. How far along are you? I assume the number of words you have written that not so is not too far from zero. This game is reading my mind. Excuse me for being a realist. I've written some stuff too. I've written some stuff. May I see it? It was so bad that, after reading it, she threw it away. It's typical for writers to do that. Just, you know. Call it. I like writing too. I understand. Oh. So what about that being rude thing? Yes. I really need to finish it in at most 2 weeks. Then I'll use the extra leak to polish some editing. That actually sounds like a good plan. I like that plan. If you can pull it off. I know, you don't need to be so cynical about it. Yes, I do. That's why you're here today. There's nobody here. I just noticed this in the back here. John, your troubles and coffee. And she had the most coffee that I have here. Just tells you something. I wrote some best short stories here, you know. Really? Glad this place could be of service. Oh, it looks like someone's coming. Ooh, someone new! A tiefling? By the way, tieflings are half-human, half-devil. It's a D&D race. That's just what I drew my, conclusions to. Hi there. Hello. Good evening. For here, miss? Yes, please. And who told you could smoke in here? Smoking a pancake? Not sure what I really want to order, though. Don't order caffeine espresso over here. It's 9 o'clock. Get something nice. That depends highly on your mood. I'm just here to meet my boyfriend. Ooh. Not planning to be awake all night. So definitely no coffee. About something chocolatey? And why are you looking at me? Look at her. It's perfect for this weather. That's a good idea, actually. Thank you. Oh, yes. Alright. Anything with chocolate in it, please. Alright, let's get creative. Milk, let's see what this makes. Milk chocolate. Oh, okay. wouldn't ask this, but yes. So you're waiting for your boyfriend? Yes, he should be here soon. Look at you now. You went from empty to 3 customers in one night. I thought this place would be more crowded. Considering it's the only coffee shop that's still open after midnight around here. Because it's the only coffee shop that still opens past midnight, mostly empty. It's... Now that you mention it, is it good for business having the coffee shop only open at night? Definitely not. Yep, what she said. I don't really know personally. Then why? I just love doing it. That sounds great! And there's always someone looking... And there's always someone longing for a warm drink at this hour. Yeah. That's fascinating. Pardon me for asking, but how can you survive running a coffee shop like this? Now that's a secret. You see, there was no discrepancy. I had most of the caffeine. My channel here is damn rich. That's the secret. Oh, I didn't know. She's exaggerating. Of course, yeah. You know, don't worry about it. Gino can manage. I'm sure this place isn't going bankrupt anytime soon. So you'll still have a weird, quiet place to meet up at night. That's good to hear. By the way, are you a regular here? I don't really have anywhere else to go. I'm a writer who works best at night and in a coffee shop. Not so many options for that. Evidently my coffee shop. Ah, no wonder. She's a pretty good writer, you know. You can find some of her stories in the Evening Whispers. Shut up! Wow, that's really interesting. What kind of things do you cover? I cover the stories of people around town. Sorry, I didn't make her perky. Personal, interesting, and weird stories. I also contribute to their short stories. I love their fiction. You wrote those stories? I hate transitioning. Thank you. I wrote most of them, but not all. That's so cool. Then are you here to write a new piece? I should be. Yes, you should. Quit procrastinating. But I don't even know what to write about. Sorry. I just kinda... That face... The face is funny. Hi. Sorry to keep you waiting, babe. It's okay. I had a nice chat with the fine folks here. Hello there. Hello. Why'd everybody just suddenly look at me? Hi, would you like to order something? Surprise me. What kind of order is that? Well, I don't really know what to order. Do you have any preferences, sir? Something bitter to keep me awake, with milk. And draw some latte art on top. Let's see what this gets us. Latte art. get insulted on my first fucking playthrough. Hope he isn't a Karen. Well, I don't even know what guy Karens are called. Kyles? No, Kyles are a completely different stereotype. Get out. Yeah. You're gonna be a douche. Just get out. I can't stand these people. Oh! Like, you could do better, Mr. Fancy Pants. Looking no good. Oh, it's perfect, though. Good. Don't complain about the coffee. Anyway, I was distracted by some work. Plus, there's the rain. You couldn't see that at work at all. Nah, stupid. Dumbo. It's okay, Bailey's. Oh, this asshole has a name. I was having a nice chat with them. You don't need to. Oh yeah, I haven't properly introduced myself. You don't need to. I'm Bailey's. Yeah, girly name. As you can see, I don't like him. For obvious reasons. Oh my, where are my manners? I haven't introduced myself either. My name is Lua. Hi, I'm Freya. Yes. Nice to meet both of you. I'm a Gino. I should have just put Gino, because usually people just call me Gino. Did you know that Freya here is a writer from the Union Whispers? Oh, really? I've done some work for them a few times. Oh? What kind of work? I gotta make her perky. I'm a freelance designer and illustrator. I've done some caricatures and infographics for the paper. Oh, great. We're dealing with these people. Happy birthday. I assume you were in contact with Steve? Yep, he's a nice guy to work with. Yeah, he's a nice guy to work with. Oh, really? .. No. He isn't. But I've dealt with worse clients. Way worse, dude. Yeah, I'm glad he's in design and visuals department. I wouldn't be able to stand working with him directly. Come on. He's tough to deal with, but definitely not the worst. Oh, of course. No matter how deep you go, there's always another layer of hell. I like that analogy. How do you usually deal with bad customers here? The only bad customers this late at night are lost drunks or criminals. That sounds really... That's rough, buddy. That sounds really bad. Nah, they're easy to handle. That's because you... Yeah, see? I'll give him the old 1-2, see? Not as good as your coffee? Would you like to have your coffee still when you come here? Thank you. I'll take that as a compliment. You're welcome. Anyway, I really need to start writing. Yes. leave you to in the hands of our friendly neighborhood barista. Me! Where are you gonna write? Oh, not far. Just over at that table in the corner so I can stalk you two. Next to the windows. That's my spot. Okay, have fun. I'll try. Good luck. Good luck, bro. Thanks. Alright, bye, Freya. You were okay. Oh, Lord. We're with the couple. Should we move to other seats, too? Nah, here is good. Again, put out the cigarette, please. Just a thought. Okay, then. So, how was your day? So I'm just listening in. It was fine. Work was nothing special. I finished my proposal early so I could get out of the office. I'm out of here. Plus, my boss was in a really good mood all day. I thought your boss was always a happy-go-lucky person. Well, he is. But today, he was happier than usual. I'm not sure what happened, but it was great seeing him smile so much. What about you? Any problems with your latest client? Yeah, this one is a pain in the ass. You know those memes that depict terrible clients? Like Karen's? And yourself? Well, I might have a bit more sympathy for you if you're facing a Karen. Well, she fits all the bills. I could go on forever complaining about her, but that won't help me a bit. You should... Normies. You should make a meme about her. And lose my current project for a minute of laughter. That might be worth it. You should ask Gino here about how to deal with annoying clients. Oh yeah, how do you usually deal with annoying customers? I throw them out the fucking door. The ones you don't need your fist to take care of. I do have my own methods. Yeah, it's called Get the F*** Out. But it wouldn't be wise to talk about customers to other customers. No, that's one good lesson to learn for the day. Oh, jeez. Oh, what's this about? I don't like the face. His face is weird. And she doesn't look like she doesn't care. Oh, great. Oh, no. Yes. So, you've talked to them. You got a problem with them talking to their parents? I did. It didn't end well. No. That's too bad. Seriously, that's too bad. I feel you. What did they say? A lot. Same. I got into a fight with my old man. That's why I'm staying at parents' place now. Okay, I wouldn't move out. I think you should reconcile your differences with your dad. Sure, you fight, but don't give up on him. You know, you can still live in the same house. I considered it. I never want to do that. I love my father. I love my mother. I love my sister. I love my dad. But I could never move away for such a thing as an argument about a relationship. Why'd it go all slam? Like the verses before Mortal Kombat or For Honor or something. I don't like it. They kick you out? You don't have to do this, you know. They're your family. I can't stand even one more second being a part of them. I might not have a stable income, but I can manage. But still! Oh, great. Here comes the argument. I don't know what they said about you last night. You don't know, excuse me. You don't know what they said about you. I'm sorry. What did they say about me? Or about my race, I assume. Forget it. I want to know. It's just the same old shit. Mumbling about how elves are holy creatures. About our immortality. About how if I outlive you, elves would want to be with an elf that's already been tainted by a lowly succubus. They're succubuses? Succubuses. Okay. You know, succubuses suck the life out of people by seducing them. I'm just gonna call them tieflings. Not saying that, you know, the racism aspect and everything is right. What I'm saying is, tiefling would make more sense. To me, at least. So, I'm just gonna call them tieflings. That's exactly what they said. Awkward silence. So this is it, then. No! I've already been so come attached, except for you. I hate you, the one on the left. Ugh. You know! Okay, it doesn't have to be. You know our families. Oh, her horns are flashing red. She's got the wee-woos. You know our families will never agree. Another silence. We can just continue like this. What do you mean? They don't need to know that we're still dating. I tried that. Doesn't work, pal. Can just continue the way we've always been, without them knowing. And then what? Do you want to be hiding our relationship for the rest of eternity? We're not like humans, you know. We can't just elope. I thought eloping was supposed to be in secret. So, it's secret. And you won't get permission because you're too old. Lua, I don't care about their permission. I'll be glad to sever my family ties if I have to. Okay. There is a difference from completely cutting off family to disregarding them. Look, family is everything. Don't disregard them. I don't like that. It just, especially growing up very close family, never do that. That's the only people who will truly have your back. Unless you do something like this, and they don't like it. But that's their fault for not unconditionally loving you. I can't let you do that. I can't let you do that. You lose your immortality. Who wants to live forever? Elves, because they're the master race? If I get to spend my life with you, I don't mind. That's really cute. I really like that. Cause who would want to live forever? I sure as hell don't want to live forever. I don't mind a bit. You're making this hard for both of us. Do you feel happy when you're with me? You shouldn't have asked that question, pal. Of course I do. Then you don't need any more reasons. You know we're perfect. Don't tell her what she knows. Let her figure it out. You just... Because that just creates friction. And that's just... Mm-mm. You don't... Yes! Yes, you do! You don't even need to look deep down. Deep down, you should... Because that's where it should be, your love. Deep down is the stuff you do unconditionally. Like, I say thank you to my veterans. Or I smile, even though they see it. They don't see it under the mask at work. I still smile. I just do it unconditionally. Just, that's what you need deep down. Trust me, we can do this together. Now that I like. You should have just said that first. Because that's implying that it's a cooperation. A jolly cooperation. Trust me, we can do this. Together. Another awkward silence. I can't think about this clearly right now. Okay, we're out of the verses thing. We'll talk later. Wait. Bro. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry, man. That sucks. That sucks, man. I'm sorry for you. That really sucks. Wow. Man. I'm sorry you had to listen to our problem. Nope. That's what the game told me about. Dot. That's alright. Coffee shop has seen all kinds of stories. I do hope yours will have a happy ending. I truly think that. Seriously. Though I really don't like you. Gross, man. I understand. It's a guy thing. Again, I hate when they just directly stare at me. It's... no. I hope so, too. Nope. Sorry, man. Do you have any alcohol? Sadly, no. That's a bummer. Well, do you have anything that's warm and that can calm me down? Do you like green tea lattes? Okay. Green tea lattes. Alright, green tea latte is green tea, milk and milk. For you. Come on, bro. You deserve it. You know what? This one's on the house. No problem. Thank you for this. By the way, are you married? Personal question. Me? No. I'm just lonely. Do you have someone you love? I love this coffee shop. But I'm pretty sure that's not the answer you're looking for. I didn't really have any expectations. Man, out of all the people in the whole world, why did I fall for her? You can't choose who you fall in love with. Agreed. It's all about this quote-unquote cosmic thing. If in your heart you truly do love her, sometimes you just gotta let her go. But in this case... Try your best, man. I get it. It's nice, and I like it. If you can, if you try hard enough. Alright, at least that's what my old man said. I thought you argued with him. He really is one pretentious elf. As most elves are. Sorry, what? But I guess all of them are. I guess I didn't need to whisper. At least you have eternity to learn and change. Or an eternity to be an eternal asshole. Anyway, I need to go now. I'll probably drink myself under until then. No! That's not how you solve your problems. Thank you, do visit again, yeah. That, I shouldn't have acted like that, I'm sorry. Just, what's wrong? You were listening from the corner. Yes, poor souls. I hope they find a way to be together. Me too. Anyway, I need to leave. I have to get up earlier than usual. Then why did you have a 3-shot espresso? Are you going to plan on sleeping tonight? Okay. I think I'm going to close up shop then after this. That's pretty early. I know. After the rest of the deliveries come in tomorrow, I'll open as usual. Okay, you have a good night then. You too. Alright. Well, that was our first day. Tea with milk mixed by pouring the two repetitively between cups that are originally from Malaysia. Woo! Alright, I'm gonna end this episode here. This is a good game, and I really think that this can be something. I really want to keep playing it. I really do. And I know I'm a bit new, but show me that you like it by liking and maybe even subscribing if you want to see the rest of the story. Thank you very much. This has been the B.I.G., as in the Big Italian Gamer. And I'll catch you later, kid.